Okay, so this video will be a follow-up to one of my previous videos when I show how to use Google Sheets data with Google Data Studio and control access to who can see which data based on their email address. Now, I had some questions how we can improve that to create multi-level access. So, for example, if we have different sales reps here, Isabella, Olivia, Jose, etc., what if we have like a department head or a manager that is supposed to be able to log in and see the data for a few of these people in the list, but each person should still only see their own data? So I made this data a lot smaller so we can test it and see how it goes. I'm gonna pretty much do what they have suggested in their documentation for a case like this and see how it goes. And most likely it should work just fine. Now, what we're gonna do here, we're gonna create another tab. I'm gonna call this one Access Control. It doesn't matter what you call this tab, that's what I called it, but the name doesn't matter. I need a nice clean list of IDs. I don't really have IDs here, I just have their names, so that's what I'm gonna use. If you have better unique identifiers, that's what you should use, but in this case, I'm gonna go with their names. So I'm just gonna go ahead and select this list and paste it over here and just get rid of all duplicates right here. So I'm gonna go under data and remove duplicates, header row. There it is. So we have our salespeople. I'm gonna go ahead and enter their emails in the next column. So this is where you need to match the correct email to the right person, and that email should be that person's Google account because it's gonna basically control with their Google account email whether they should be able to see their data or not. So for Edward, I'm gonna enter my email so I can test and make sure this works. So far, this is pretty much the same thing I did in my previous video. What I'm gonna do different here is that I'm gonna also do another level of access. So the way we're gonna do this, let's say we're gonna have a manager who should be able to see Isabella's data, Jake's data, and Edward's data right here. So this one that I've entered my email, I should be able to only see Edward's data. And for this, I'm gonna enter another email I can actually log in to check that I can see Isabella, Jake, and Edward. And all I'm gonna do is just basically repeat the same email for all three of them. That's pretty much it. Unlike the previous video, I'm not gonna do a VLOOKUP and I'm not gonna add an email column here. I'm just gonna leave these separate. The key thing here is that for the key lines here that we should give access to a certain email, we should just make sure that particular, in this case, name appears in this table with an email next to it. And you could obviously repeat the same name multiple times. Like you can see, I did Edward twice, and once I give access to this email, and then I list Edward again, and I give another email again. Okay, so now that we got this going, let's go ahead and go to Data Studio. So I'm under datastudio.google.com. Right there, I'm gonna go ahead and create a new blank report. And we're gonna connect to that spreadsheet from our Google Drive. So if you have a long list of worksheets, you just need to search and find the one you actually need. I'm gonna go ahead and click on the one I was just working with. And as you can see, we have two worksheets. You remember we have new data, which is our data, and we have access control, which is that second one I've made. So I'm gonna start with that access control worksheet, the second one, and I'm gonna use the first column as headers. That's great. I'm gonna press add to report. So for now, this data is not filtered or anything. It's just using that table to create some report that really doesn't make sense. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna go ahead and go to this data right here and add it the data we just connected to, that access control table. And we're going to filter this by email right here. I'm going to click filter by email. I'm going to check this box. I'm going to choose that email column that I've created myself. And as you can see, I need to now grant access to be able to view the report. And this was that email that I was using for one of those lines for Edward. Good enough. I'm going to click allow and click done. And you can see now I can only get Edward's stuff after I did this. But this is just that access control table because by itself, it doesn't really have anything useful for us for reports. But this is the table we're going to use to filter our other tables. Now, what we need to do, we need to add another data source to this, which is going to be our first worksheet at this point. So I'm going to start by going here under add data. And I'm going to connect again to Google Sheets and select that same spreadsheet. So there it is. I'm going to click on this, choose that new data, which is pretty much this right here, and use the first row as headers, click add. Add to report, and that's now in there. So once that data source is connected, then I'm gonna go ahead and click on this blend data. So now basically I'm gonna blend that new source that I did to my previous source right here. I'm gonna click blend data, and see, this is our previous one with emails for access control, and I'm gonna click on this add another data source, and choose that connection that I did. It's going to be one of these two. It's going to be very hard to tell which one it is, but it wasn't the first one because this has these three columns. So I'm going to go ahead and remove that one and click and check the second in the list right here. So there it is. Those are the columns. Good. So I need to add those columns, whether they're going to be dimension or metric or whatever. So I'm going to choose which columns I'm going to need for my reporting. So I'll go ahead and pretty much just use all of them. I'll use date, I'll do region. And I'm gonna add metrics. So for metrics here, I'm gonna use this sales amounts. And I guess record count for this should be good too. I probably want to give this a little different name, so I'm gonna edit this and call this just count. And that's for making sure I don't confuse it with this other record count here. So we have this count here, we did this. So at this point, the important part is gonna be to choose the right join key from both tables. So join key is gonna be that common key column. In my case, I was using that sales rep's name, but remember that if you have a better key, use that instead. So for me, from this table, see I have sales rep, from this table, which is correct. Now, I named my column name the same, but if you didn't have the same column name, you would have to just drag it over. See, it automatically figured it out. So sales rep from this two. So that makes the connection between these two. I'm gonna go ahead and hit save. So now we have our blended data set. So first of all, I'm gonna remove this record count because that really doesn't mean anything. That's the record count from our access control table. That doesn't really mean much for our reporting. I'm gonna make this a little bigger here so we can see what we got. So I have sales reps named twice. I'm gonna remove one of those. So I'm just gonna get rid of all of these, whatever's in here, and just start over from scratch to avoid any confusion. I'm deleting all of these dimensions. In metrics, I'm gonna put sales, which is in here. I'm gonna start with that. Now in my dimensions, I'm gonna add all the other columns I'm gonna need here. So I'll do like date, I'll do sales rep's name, region, category. So that looks pretty good. Let's just resize these columns. In this video, I'm not gonna go over design changes and any of that stuff. I'm just gonna leave everything standard. Just watch my previous video or better my Data Studio videos if you want to do more fancy stuff here. But here, what I want to show you is that we currently just get records for Edward. So I logged in with that email that I attached to AdWord, and that's what I got. All I get is AdWord's results. So if we go back to our table, we should see those are three records matching AdWord. So here, see, we have these two and this. So far, filtering works for one user. Let's also just throw in a quick pivot table here too. And we'll just do sales and count, I guess. Actually, these are columns. We don't need those. Just sales under matrix is good. Maybe we'll add count under matrix too. And maybe for just something here on the left, we don't really need this record count as a dimension. I'll add something like sales rep. That should just give us the name of AdWord and the total. See, it says AdWord did 3 sales, which we can see right here. And the total for all of those was this much. That's good enough for summary. Again, you can do more if you wanted to. But that creates my report. I'm going to go ahead and name this one report for all. And at this point, I should be able to just share this report with other users. So if you remember, I did create that second user that I was trying to give access to 3 different reps. So I'm going to go to share and enter that email here. And just press OK. So that person should be able to view this report. Let's go and log in as that person to Data Studio and see what we can actually see. So here we are now logged in as that user. So this may take a little bit to show up here. As you can see, I logged in, but I can see it here. Sometimes you may have to basically click shared with me. Sometimes you may have to refresh or go under shared with me option and see that showed up, one report for all, but it may take a little bit sometimes. So I'm going to go ahead and open that now as this other user. And as you can see, as I'm logged in as that user, it's asking me to grant permission as that user for this. I'm going to click allow. And let's just zoom in a tiny bit. And if you look here, as this user, I'm able to see information for Jake, Isabella, and Edward for all 3 of them. And then my pivot table shows totals for all 3 of those sales reps. And just to check that's correct, if we go back to our spreadsheet, this is the other account. Let's go back to Data Studio and go to Access Control. See here to this email, I have assigned Isabella, Jake, and Edward. And that's exactly what I get here, Jake, Isabella, and Edward. So now using this structure, we can actually do this control. And if we want to have one user who can see different data sets, we can actually do it by simply just adding those emails here to this table. Just make sure if you go and modify your access table or your data, you go back and open your report and refresh data. And that should do it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.